Hindus, mata bulat. The man he loves to hate, Takalani Ngawo. This is the IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship, and it's scheduled for 12 rounds. And your officials for this particular fight are none other than Judge Alfred Bakwani, Neville Holtz, and Jean van Nieuwenhuizen. The supervisor for this fight hails from Tanzania, so let's give him a nice warm round of applause. Onesco Ngowi. Let me introduce the principals to you right now. He weighed in at 55.32 kilograms. He's the former WBC international champion. He's the former IBO international champion. He has a fight record of 30 fights, 25 wins, 14 by knockout, lost 3, drawn 2. He goes by the name of Jeffrey Marvelous Mongoose Matabula. He's a opponent tonight. A man who needs no introduction to the South African ring. He is, of course, the IBF world champion. He weighed in at 55.18 kilograms with a fight record of 39. 18 by knockout. He's only lost six. Soweto Kaltang's very own Takalani the Panther Ngovu. Now when the bell rings and the action begins in this four-cornered ring, the third man will be referee Wally Snowball. Boxers.
I'm going to lock her alongside me, Silence Mabuza, for this most anticipated fight in South Africa. An IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship over 12 rounds between Takalani the Panther Ndlovu and Geoffrey Marvelous Mongoose Matebula. Well, the 34-year-old Ndlovu certainly favoured by many, but a bit of a grudge rematch as they meet for the second time. It was Ndlovu who emerged victorious the first time that they met, and certainly Matebula, better prepared, comes into this fight with a lot more confidence, and the tail of the tape suggests that Matebula, with his reach advantage and his height advantage, might make it count tonight. But he's up against a slightly more experienced fighter. Both have impressive records, though. Silence, what do you make of this title bout?
This is a highly anticipated fight for the night. Number one, as you can see, Takalani Ndlovu, the champion, he's very clinical in his punch throwing, and he's very accurate. Whilst Geoffrey Matebula, he prides with his reach of advantage, and he throws a lot of punches. The boys, they have been into the ring, in the very same ring, in the very same arena before. That was 2010. We need to see who is going to win this fight tonight. But both boxers, they are fit and ready to take it on.
Certainly are. Both boxers having in recent years registered victories over men like Oscar Chauke, but certainly Takalani Ndlovu, his victory over Steve Molitor, the Canadian, to claim the IBF Super Bantamweight title, or the IBF Junior Featherweight title, if you prefer. A man that beat Ndlovu at their first time of asking in Canada, brought him out to South Africa and managed to claim victory and the belt. He looks to defend it against Matebula tonight. But these boxers, early indications are that they're willing to go toe-to-toe with one another. And you so usually expect that from grudge matches, and certainly matches or rematches or title deciders. Unlike some of the bouts that we saw on the undercard, this is going to be one of those where the boxers are going to be willing to go toe-to-toe for the duration of the fight.
It is very evident this is a weight class boxing. You can see Zindala Zombile, Geoffrey Matebula, Takalani Ndlovu. Ziyashana lensizwa lezi. You have round number one lo, kepha ikehlo niphenye. Zombile zifuna ukuwina lo mdlalo wanamhlanje. Uyambona Geoffrey Matebula ubuyisele kakhulu namhlanje. Uyayishaya izisebenzi zakhe ezinde. Takalani Ndlovu, he is very popular in his defense. They are both throwing power punches. It's first round. It is hot.
It is hot indeed. It's been titled African Glory 2. And it's all about African Glory. The Panther up against the Mongoose Ndlovu. He's is a lot more crouched in his start. He's got great balance. And you expect that from somebody who's fought at the highest level. Matebula slightly more upright, but does like to use that reach advantage. These boxers, though, are both orthodox boxers, no southpaw. So nothing overly difficult for either one of the opponents to worry about, certainly in terms of stance. These two sizing each other up, and a little holding going on.
The difference between the two boxers, Dwayne, is that Takalani Ndlovu is very comfortable in boxing against a boxer. And Geoffrey Matebula, he's a slack fist. What he wants to do, he tries to play it rough. But right now, it's the first round. Both boxers, they are holding, they are playing it rough. And this is Geoffrey Matebula's step. This is how he likes the fight.
Well, complaints certainly from the Panthers' camp, from Marvelous's camp, about a few possible rabbit punches, but no call from referee Wally Snowball. So the end of round one, and boxers signaling their intentions. So fighting out of the No Mercy gym, Takalani the Panther Ndlovu, the champion, IBF world champion, rated by Ring Magazine at number six in the junior featherweight division. The man who's lost only six of his 39 bouts, bringing up number 40 and hoping to claim victory once again, successfully defend his title. But the Mongoose, the mandatory challenger, is a man who is looking to take it away from him. He's fought for championships before. He's claimed WBC international featherweight titles before as well. A former South African super bantamweight title holder as well is Jeffrey Matabula.
This is the highly rated weight division in our country. As we can remember, we had Welcome Nita fighting for the very same title. We have Beyond the Beast, Pungu. We had the likes of Lisogonolo, Hands of Tony Daba, for light featherweight. Right now, it is Jeffrey Matabula against Takalani Ndlovu. Zombili ziyashaya, ayike funi bele muva. But right now, as you can see, Takalani Ndlovu is the one that's pushing Jeffrey Matabula backwards.
Ollie Snowball saying for the second time that Jeffrey Matabula has just landed punches a little low on the body of Ndlovu. So Wally Snowball with an early warning, no points deductions as yet. Good little left coming in from Ndlovu. Do boxers still sizing one another up, but the pace has slowed down just slightly. Nice little jab and looking for the combination blow. Matabula, who's seemingly the aggressor in this second round so far. But the Panther himself now guilty of landing blows that are just a little too low in the eye of referee Wally Snowball, who's been right on the money so far.
Jeffrey Matabula is not the boxer who's very comfortable fighting on his back foot. And right now, Takalani Ndlovu, he's putting Jeffrey Matabula on his back. Right now, what you see right now, Jeffrey Matabula, he tries to make sure that he's pushing Takalani Ndlovu backwards. But Takalani, he is the champion. He is ruling this ring. He's controlling the fight.
Well, that's the thing. If you've got the momentum going forward, you can easily push your opponent into the ring. And as you say, you rightly say, Matabula, despite his attempts to land those punches on Ndlovu, he's not exactly driving Ndlovu back. And when you fail to get that momentum moving as opposed to your the opponent in the ring with you, things can go horribly wrong. You can get driven back into the ropes. You can find yourself caught as... in some cases, the superior boxer takes charge. But who is the superior boxer is what we're aiming to find out over 12 rounds tonight. IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. It's Ndlovu against Matabula.
Credibility. This is boxing. This is what's happening. They will say local is lekel.
Another warning from Wally Snowball, don't push your man down. But this is certainly a star-studded card for African Glory 2. And these are the two men who highlight the fight card. Again, looking to land that big left is Matabula. He's using it more than simply as a jab, a nice little body landed. And now, wanting the combinations is Global coming in with the punches.
This is the fight that we all like to see. We are waiting for Jeffrey Matabula to stand at least at the center of the ring and start throwing crisp punches and the thrilling punches. But right now, Takalani Ndlovu, he is the one that's pushing forward and making sure that he stamps his authority that says, I am the champion tonight.
He certainly imposed his himself on his opponents in the opening two rounds.
We got a double jab. Okay. He's slipping, bang, throwing right hand when you jab once. I want plenty fines this round. Plenty fines and double jab, three jab. He's on your left. The centers are working. He's gonna go back and then he's gonna go there. So center, step here, pick him up. Okay. Come on. But here, it's all the time. It's right. So far it's good, but when he misses over your head, I need you to work.
So welcome back to Carnival City. It's the Big Top Arena as Bronco Sports brings you African Glory 2. It's IBF title action here from the Big Top Arena. It's certainly premier action from Africa's premier promoter, the only man to have been voted the IBF's promoter of the world for 3 years in a row. Bear in mind, we've got a fight down in East London next weekend for you. If you're going to be down in East London, it is IBF mini flyweight crown that's up for grabs. And of course, Nati Joy against Katasunari Takayama. Down in East London is the fight. Make sure you get on down and watch the match. And right now, the focus very much on the Panther against the Mongoose. But still, Takalani Ndlovu imposing himself on his opponent by constantly moving forward. But he does need to land a few more punches. He's not landing the body blows that you would expect from Takalani Ndlovu. Credit to the movement of Matabula.
Jeffrey Matebula, he is the awkward boxer in terms of his stance. It's very difficult to hit such an awkward boxer simply because he is tall. Jeffrey Matebula mude lo mfana uyasebenzisa ingalo ezinde. Takala Ndlovu uyangena weziqinisa sokuthi ushaya ibhakele inamandla eyibonakalayo. Labafana ababili bashaya ibhakele inamandla, kodwa kubalekile la ukuthi uJeffrey Matebula wenza sure ukuthi ibhakele ishaya uTakala Ndlovu ayihlali esiswini noma ayihlali ebusweni bakhe la uJeffrey Matebula. The mangoes zindala zombili.
It's great to see how Matebula is adapting at the moment, because while he's not able to drive Ndlovu back, what he's able to do is he's able to land a couple of punches and move, and that's what he's been impressive with so far in this round. His movement through the ring, great footwork, lands a couple of punches, gets the move on the way if he's not pushing Ndlovu backwards. And this is something that certainly a strategy that Matebula could gain some success with if he continues to fight this way. But one body blow landed by Ndlovu. Matebula just a little jab through between the gloves of Ndlovu. It was just holding those hands a little high, a little holding coming in. Takala a break from referee Snowball.
Takala Matebula, he is the boxer that is he's a body puncher. He throws a lot of body punches. Kepha manje we are seeing Jeffrey Matebula throwing body punches. Takala Ndlovu umfana la owaziwa kakhulu ngokushaya ibhakela ashaya isiswini, indoda very well. Kodwa namhlanje sibona uJeffrey Matebula uyena oshaya ibhakela la ashaya isiswini abuye ekhanda. Zinde ibhakela zaka Jeffrey Matebula. Jeffrey Matebula i-left hand yakhe iyahla kakhulu. He is dropping his left hand, Jeffrey Matebula, and is using those long arms to make sure that is keeping Takala Ndlovu at bay.
And he's managing to do that infinitely better in this third round as we approach the final 30 seconds of round number three. Looking a little wary from throwing the punches, but he's backed himself into a corner, and again, great movement out. He's not finding himself caught up against the ropes, which is something that he would need to be wary of, being driven back by his opponent. Nice left from Ndlovu. Lands the left. He's been throwing a few wildly. Lands another big left now. And some power blows coming in from Ndlovu, but we're into the final 10 seconds. A little clinching going on from the two boxers again. Good bobbing and weaving, but still a few punches being landed. None of them comfortably, though, as we hit the end of round number three.
Two distinctions between the two boxers. Takala Ndlovu is very economical. He never works any punches as Jeffrey Matebula. He throws four or five, but then all of them, they don't land.
Well, if you're a big fan next Friday, you must pick up your bear in mind Broncos focus moving to East London for a boxing bonanza. Kusunati Joy against Katsunara Takayama of Japan for the IBF mini flyweight crown. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter, but tonight the focus on African glory too. This IBF title action, it is the Panther against the marvelous mongoose Matebula, who had a few more blows landed in the second half, but a good strong finish from Ndlovu. But you go back to 2 years ago and the initial meeting between these two. Start of round number four. This the highly anticipated rematch for the IBF junior featherweight crown here at the Big Top Arena at Carnival City. Rather controversial, their meeting in 2010, I suppose, looking at the rather contrasting scorecards on the evening, and certainly Matebula's camp following the decisions of the judges, only out for Nivenes, and it scored in favor of Matebula on the evening. But now the two going toe-to-toe. Watch your head. Caught from Wally Snowball as the two heads bob and weave almost together at one stage. But Ndlovu trying to land the power punches, and Matebula swinging a little wildly.
Whoa. Now umdlalo ke manje uyaliwa la. Jeffrey Matebula ushaya ibhakele inamandla, kodwa sibona shaya khulu ngamandla la. Takala Ndlovu ubuyile, uTakala Ndlovu wenza into esimjwayele ngayo, ukushaya esiswini abuye futhi akhuphuke phezulu. This is what we see Jeffrey Matebula right now trying to do, to make sure that he's throwing as much punches as he can. But one thing that Jeffrey Matebula must not do, he must not overwork himself. It's still early in the rounds. Takala Ndlovu is very economical in punch. Look at that. 1-2, they are landing crisp on Jeffrey Matebula's face.
Well, that's the worry now for Matebula, is Ndlovu is starting to land a lot more clean punches. Matebula is not having any power in the punches that he is landing. Ndlovu seemingly completely unbothered by any of Matebula's attempts to make a clean connection. Matebula being driven into a corner, and he's not backing out of it now. Eventually he does. But it's such a contrast from the last round where he was moving so cleanly. Great movement around the ring. Suddenly, Matebula is looking a lot more tired. And while a good weave came in, he's is looking far from the man who was bouncing around. 1-2 combinations, jump. 1-2, nice movement that he was in the last round. Another body blow from Global.
Jeffrey Matebula right now, he's fighting Takalani Ndlovu's fight. Jeffrey Matebula, he needs to run around and confuse Takalani Ndlovu. But Jeffrey Matebula, he is moving slow. And Takalani Ndlovu is just catching Jeffrey Matebula right at the center of the ring. Takalani Ndlovu, the champion of the world, Jeffrey Matebula. When the show, Takalani Ndlovu, who is throwing the most powerful punches.
Ndlovu is certainly getting the better of Matebula. In round number four, in terms of landing superior punches, cleaner punches, crisper punches, another left makes a combination. Trying to box his way off the rings. Landing on the head of Ndlovu, but nothing hurting the champion. It's the champion who is imposing himself. But now, a little slip, nearly saw him go into the rings with Matebula, but he looks fresh and confident at the conclusion of round number four.
Jeffrey Matebula.
So African Glory 2 tonight, IBF title action from Carnival City. It's live on SABC2. Kosunati Joy, Katasunari Takayama is going to be next Friday down in East London. Make sure you go and watch the IBF mini flyweight crown if you're in the area. It's premier action from Africa's premier promoter, the only man who's been voted IBF's promoter of the world for 3 years in a row, Branko Milankovic, the man behind Branko Sports, and of course tonight's bout. In association with Gauteng, home of champions in Carnival City Casino. And African Glory 2 so far is living up to expectation. These two boxers have showed a great deal of different strategies, different tactics, as a big right comes in from Ndlovu.
This is what
took it cleanly though.
This is what we don't want to see between Jeffrey Matebula dropping that left hand, because Takalani Ndlovu has got a very vicious straight right. We saw that happening. He dropped the left, Jeffrey Matebula, and Takalani Ndlovu, he threw a very powerful right which landed crisp on the face of Jeffrey Matebula.
Well, the one thing that nobody could ever accuse Takalani Ndlovu of being is somebody who lacks stamina. He's got a great endurance. He's got the ability to go 12 rounds if indeed the fight is going to go that far. Matebula might be a little more concerned in terms of taking the fight the distance. Again, being driven back, landing the blows, but into the arms of Matebula, who's laying them up a little more frequently now in protection. But those arms are dropping overall, and if Ndlovu times it right, could get in the blow that proves decisive in this fight.
Takalani Ndlovu, uya umpana la opusha uJeffrey Matebula muva. Jeffrey Matebula uya shaya imbili, ushaya intata, shaya ezine. Takalani Ndlovu ushaya ezimbili, zihlale zonke, zihlale busweni lapho. Jeffrey Matebula umile, udinga ukuthi ashaye ngamanje Jeffrey Matebula. Jeffrey Matebula needs to work even more harder, but make sure that whatever punch he's throwing, it lands, because Takalani Ndlovu, he throws all the crisp punches.
But it's not to say that Matebula is out of this fight, not by any stretch of the imagination. He's certainly not having the advantage, but in boxing, the great thing about bouts is how uncertain they can be, and how often somebody who's dominated a fight for 10 rounds can suddenly lose it with one blow. All it needs is a clean left, a clean right, great uppercuts.
This is still early in the fight. We can see Takalani Ndlovu is still pushing Jeffrey Matebula backwards. Jeffrey Matebula uyabamba ubele muva akasashaya ibhakela eyininga kakhulu. Jeffrey Matebula ziyehla izandla, he's dropping his hands. I don't know whether Jeffrey Matebula is tired or what, but one thing for sure, a boxer from Nicaragua is always fit when it comes to the fight.
Yes, indeed. But you've got to say that despite the fact that Ndlovu's landed all these punches, he hasn't drawn blood. He's not got the eye swollen. So he's not really doing as much damage as he would have hoped to his opponent tonight. Matabula's taking the body blows. Are they wearing him out? Most likely. But Ndlovu for now is looking slightly healthier, fitter, and the man likely to go the distance. But the fact that Matabula is able to get himself out of the corner, out of the off the ring when he's back into that situation is suggests that there's still life in the fighter and that he's not out of this fight.
Jeffrey Matabula, he is the boxer that's sitting down in every interval. See now, that was a straight right I was talking about. Jeffrey Matabula dropped the left, and Takrani Ndlovu, he threw a straight right. Jeffrey Matabula was a uppercut, but umlomo uvulekile. Uhlala phansi Jeffrey Matabula on the intervals, but Takrani Ndlovu, he is standing up even on the intervals. That shows how fit the boxers can be.
Well, Takrani Ndlovu is... he's got slightly more experience as well, and as Silence rightly mentions, even during the breaks, he's not resting on his bench in his corner. Instead, the man in the red corner, Tagalani Ndlovu, is instead standing, intimidating his opponent, trying any psychological ploy to gain an advantage. Matabula is not playing his game though, and he's looking to gain or use all the advantages he has, certainly in height and reach, to try to outbox Ndlovu.
Uyaliwa lana namhlanje. Jeffrey Matabula uyiqelenzelela ichallenger. Takalani Ndlovu, he is the champion. Uyaliwa la. Ngithatha ukubona ukwazi lana uTakalani Ndlovu, uyu mfana ofuna ukuqeda lo mdlalo ngoba before uTakalani Ndlovu he won the fight, but then Jeffrey Matabula said no, I was the one. But the boys, they said tonight we don't have to leave the fight to the judges. We need to finish this now here, and they finish.
Alfred Bukwana, Neville Hortz, and Jaap van Nieuwenhuizen are the three judges for tonight's bout. This IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. Over 12 rounds, we're in round number 6. And in recent times, I can tell you that Takalani Ndlovu has lost his knockout edge. He's gone the distance in his last 7 fights. So in terms of the knockout blow, it's been lacking over the last 4-odd years. But that doesn't mean that he is an inferior boxer. He's a champion, and he's looking to prove it again with a successful title defense against Jeffrey Matabula, and of course claim a second successive victory over the man who fights from Nick Durant's corner. Durant's boxing against No Mercy Gym.
This is one of the very tough weight division, and it's the most exciting weight division in our country, because we've got the likes of Makbut Sinyabi, who also is our South African junior featherweight champion. I'd love to see Makbut Sinyabi fighting against Jeffrey Matabula or Takalani Ndlovu. But right now, Takalani Ndlovu, he is pushing Jeffrey Matabula backwards.
Matabula continues to find himself on the back foot and more toward the ropes, as Ndlovu just oozes confidence. Ndlovu's stance, so impressive, hasn't changed. Crouched over, Matabula slightly more upright, swinging wildly at times and showing signs of tiredness.
Jeffrey Matabula is doing what is very famous on. He's throwing 3-4 punches, but one thing that he's doing wrong, he doesn't make sure that those punches land, because every punch that you miss, it takes away the power.
It does. It takes away a great deal of energy. Throwing punches and missing your opponents takes probably more energy than it does landing the punches, or in fact having punches landed on you, taking the blows. Both these boxers have a chin though. They're not easy boxers to knock out, but both will hope that they have what it takes to take out their opponent. Right now, I'd suggest that Ndlovu is the boxer who's really styling his way to a title defense rather than fighting his way. Matabula trying to throw those wild punches and hoping with every swing that he can land a miracle punch. So tonight, Bronco Sports, he's the man behind it, brings you African Glory 2, this IBF title action from the Big Top Arena here at Carnival City, live on SABC 2. to focus on East London next Friday with Kusunata Joy and Katsunara Takayama. IBF mini flyweight crown up for grabs. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter. And Marvelous Mongoose taking a couple of punches here as the Panther gets tucked in. He's on the hunt, is the Panther, and it looks like Mongoose is on the menu. It's certainly not great defense from Matabula. Even when he does get the arms up, sometimes just far too big a gap between the gloves. Matabula is taking an extra odd second to get up off the bench. Coming into round number 7. Ndlovu still standing in the corner.
Jeffrey Matabula is very suspicious on dropping his guards, whilst Takalani Ndlovu is always on his guards and making sure that he's throwing the power punches. But Jeffrey Matabula, round number 6, he came back very strong, trying to make sure that he is winning the round and getting on the back. Jeffrey Matabula lo siyambona ke manje uyimisele ziyaphakama kancane izandla, kodwa kubalekile la ukuthi kufanele ukuthi ashaye ibhakela ezothi uma wakhwela umzuliswano ube uye ohambe phambili. Wayeshaye left Jeffrey Matabula, ushintshile umfana la, uye manje umile at the center of the ring. Akasabuyele mu. He's not going backwards, Jeffrey Matabula.
That's exactly what you want now. Matabula to stand firm and take this toe-to-toe at the center of the ring. You want to see the two boxers fighting at the center of the ring. But Ndlovu again, imposed. That's his strategy tonight, and he's trying to fight his own way. But he's still managing to take the punches. A few of them landed by Matabula, in particular a nice left. Oh, and this time he does find a combination. And that's the type of thing that Matabula needs to do. If he can land a couple of those big punches, he can take the title away from Ndlovu in a matter of seconds. But Ndlovu needs to go back to what he was doing. Quick movement, push forward, use the power rather than be intimidated by the reach advantage of his opponent.
Jeffrey Matabula is looking very comfortable in the center of the ring. But now, once he starts to move, as he's doing right now, and uses the rope, he looks very clumsy. And Takalani Ndlovu, that's his tap. He needs to always attack you. Whoa. Straight right, Yatala. Jeffrey Matabula, he needs to leave that left hand because here is Mfake Ngozinla. Zizibambeni insizwa la Jeffrey Matabula, uTakalani Ndlovu. Zidlalile 2010. Sifunukuwa namhlanje 2012 lo ukuthubani la ozophuma being the champion. Kubani uManqoba? Who is the winner tonight?
Well, Jeffrey is the call all around the ring as they sense a resurgence from Nick Durant's boxer. Matabula looking to bring in a couple of heavy lifts. He's not exactly landed any haymakers, but he's certainly getting a few more punches in round number 7. Matabula, a tired right coming in towards Ndlovu, who still looks a very confident boxer, trying to box like a champion, but finds himself off balance a few times in this round. And that might just be the difference. Perhaps one of those blows has caused the difference. Ndlovu is not quite as steady as he was just last round.
Exactly, Jeffrey Takalani Ndlovu here, what we can see, he's always just moving, he's using the short steps to attack Jeffrey Matabula. Jeffrey Matabula, his punches, they are not actually powerful as they were before, but now the guard, it's very down. He's starting to become comfortable. One mistake Jeffrey Matabula, he needs not to do, is to get too relaxed and play around. This is IPF, it's a well tightly fight. We need to be serious on this one.
Peter Mensah watches on. Vuzo Mbebe, who's the man who'll be heading up the organization for the 2013 Africa Cup of Nations. But this is where Matabula really landed a couple of big punches. Yes, Ndlovu responded with a couple of his own. But that left eye of Ndlovu is starting to look just a little swollen, and it might very well have been from that right.
It's because of the overarm right that Jeffrey Matabula is always throwing. He is, Jeffrey Matabula, the one that's hitting the body more than Takalani Ndlovu on this one.
Well, Matabula landed a couple of really big blows, and that left eye is certainly not close to being swollen shut, but it's just looking a little more closed than the opponent. That's the opponent, Matabula, fighting out of Durant's gym. IBF title fight. This World Junior Featherweight Championship will be decided over 12 rounds. The man who fights out of Brakpan in Gauteng, Jeffrey the Mongoose Matabula, up against IBF world champion, ranked number 6 by Ring Magazine, the Panther Ndlovu. And after the dominance that Matabula showed in the last round, wanting to try to respond immediately, and Ndlovu is landing a couple of punches, but Matabula is saying, I'm going to take you toe-to-toe, and I'm not going to back down.
Both boxers are revived right now. You can see the number of punches that they are throwing. And one good thing that I love now, they are using the center of the ring. They are not always using the ropes. Jeffrey Matabula, he is now trying to throw more punches. Jeffrey Matabula, umfano imisela kakhulu, uye sebenzisa ingalo zakhe ezinde, uye phonsa iJeff, iyahlala. Utakala Ndlovu, umile, uthangi indawo Jeffrey Matabula. Iqhuda manikile, uya shout Jeffrey Matabula, yahlala esiswini. Kwangayo utakala Ndlovu naye ngabuye futhi enze njalo, athi ashadume ngazo to hit the body and come back on top.
Well, Jeffrey Matabula, interestingly, has only fought twice since he lost to Takalani Ndlovu back in September of 2010. But in that time, there's not been a great deal of fighting either from his opponent, Takalani Ndlovu, who's only had four fights in the last 2.5 odd years. So between the two, not quite showing any ring rustiness.
Jeffrey Matabula there, he's using the ring very well. He is pretending as if he's going to the corner, then he switches and twists. This is what we like to see in boxing. You need to tell your opponent, thinking maybe doing this when doing the other thing.
Good movement from Jeffrey Matabula in particular, while the stance of Ndlovu has been impressively holding as the warning from Wally Snowball. He has not come close to suggesting any points deductions are on the cards tonight, but just trying to man-manage both boxers.
Powerful right hand, it has landed on Jeffrey Matabula's face. Utakalani Ndlovu lo, ulogu mile, uyamphusha Jeffrey Matabula. Gabu Jeffrey Matabula, he is the challenger. He's the one that says, tonight, this IBF belt, ngiyayithatha ngihamba nayo, I'm taking this belt away.
Interesting to note, just our Matabula, who was standing with a slightly wider stance in his feet earlier on in the round, his feet are coming a lot more closer together. He's standing even more upright than he was at the start of the bout. And perhaps just signs of tiredness. But Ndlovu, who looked to have been hurt in round number 7, is looking strong again in round number 8. Taking another couple of taps to the forehead, but no decisive blows. Another left landed by Matabula as Ndlovu lands a couple of jabs. Going for the gum guard now is Ndlovu, getting caught near the ropes, but still not landing the punches. Ndlovu again. Matabula's movement has been most impressive in avoiding some of those big blows, but he is still far from dominating this fight, I suggest, Jeffrey Matabula. So welcome back to the Big Top Arena. It is Carnival City as Bronco Sports brings you African glory to the IBF title action. On the cards tonight is the big fight, the IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. That's the man that is going to fight the victor. Well, he's watching on with a great deal of interest. Rated number 3.
That's a handsome boy, a boxer we've seen here. This is our current South African junior featherweight champion, which is Makbutsi Nyabi. He's rated number 3 by IPF. Anytime soon, he might fight the winner of the two. I said it before, I'm saying it now. This is a very, very powerful division in our country. Makbutsi Nyabi, Takalani Ndlovu, Jeffrey Matabula. Takalani Ndlovu will be eligible right now. Jeffrey Matabula, he's throwing the punches. Body blows and finishes on top. 4, 5, 6 punches. Ziyasha Namanji. This is the mix, this is what you want to see.
Well, perhaps this is, it is certainly what you want to see, but both these fighters having fought international opponents. The difference, though, is Matabula's fought all his fights in South Africa. Takalani Ndlovu's got the experience of having fought in Mexico. He's fought in Canada. He's fought in the United States. He's fought some of the biggest names in boxing. He's fought Guerrero. I mean, he lost out to Molitor and then came back and beat Molitor. He's taken on Giovanni Caro in Mexico, and he's beaten him. So Takalani Ndlovu has got to say, he's got the superior pedigree when it comes to these boxers. You fought Rafael Marquez, probably one of the greatest boxers ever. You fought him twice over in the States. What does that add to the boxer's pedigree?
I agree with you, Dwayne, on that one, because now what actually happens here, you come back with more confidence and you know the experience is there. But one thing I can say, the local fights, those are the most difficult fights, because to grow up together, we know each other, and now the pride, it's always the telling point that who's the best in the country.
Well, this is almost bordering on the ridiculous as the two get to know each other a little better. And Ronnie Snabel decides he's going to send a warning the way of Matabula. But these two boxers both looking a little weary now in round number 9 of 12 in this IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. It's Ndlovu who's standing, biding his time, just feeling out Matabula, who swings wildly and doesn't really connect, but lands a few combinations. Needs to focus on a point and perhaps go for it.
Jeffrey Matabula is back. As you can see, he is the one now that's throwing more punches. Ushayi Bagale in a man, Jeffrey Matabula, ziyabonakala la. But one thing that I don't like Jeffrey Matabula to do, once he gets you, he starts to be too relaxed and too comfortable, and he makes a lot of mistakes. You don't want to see that. This is an IPF world title fight. You need to be extra careful because every second counts.
Doesn't matter how dominant you are in the ring, you find yourself on the receiving end from your opponent if you do get overly cocky or if you do drop your guard. It's happened so often. A boxer will be dominant 10 rounds of 12 and in the 11th take a blow to the chin. Both these boxers throwing a few slightly less venomous punches in round number 9. 3 rounds to go. It's Tangalani Ndlovu taking on Jeffrey Matabula for this IBF Junior Featherweight crown. Some nice bloody blows landed by Matabula. And as you mentioned, Silence, there were some decent punches that Matabula started to come back with. And yes, in these latter rounds, looked like he's got a second wind.
This is the round that Jeffrey Matabula has come back very strong, and the previous round. What we need to see from Jeffrey Matabula is to stand there and throw punches. Don't play around.
He's staring down his opponents. He believes that he can beat Tangalani Ndlovu tonight. Ndlovu remains standing throughout his break between rounds. So into round number 10 we go. Both corners a little slow in getting their boxes out of the corners. So into round number 10, Matabula comes out with intent, doesn't quite land his opening strike, but Ndlovu responds with a little jab just between the gloves, landing the left now. And Ndlovu going about it a little more deliberately, but he's landing some of those left jabs.
Now this is a very closely concerted fight, because now Jeffrey Matabula is also coming back with his strong punches, whilst Tangalani Ndlovu, he was relaxed in the past two rounds, but still, it's still early. This is a championship round, round number 10. Both boxers, they are still fit, they are still there, they are fighting. Ziyashayana, Okshio, Zindala Zombili, Ayike Punukovu Pondo, Yinyinguzo Melipu Mespayen, Orwa Umuzo Uti, Yiyipi, which is the one that's going to come up top tonight.
Well, now look at this. This is the first time that we're starting to see. Mongoose is pushing back the Panther just slightly, ever so slightly, and Ndlovu is starting to box on his back foot. He's got some weight on his heels, and that'll send a signal to Matabula that I'm doing something right. And he'll be pushing for, look at that again, Ndlovu is starting to step back, which we've not seen in previous rounds. He's continued to take the punches and move forward, but now Ndlovu is.
Tangalani Ndlovu is not comfortable fighting on his back foot, but now Jeffrey Matabula, he tried to push back Tangalani Ndlovu. Yet again, he's still the one that's moving back. He needs to stay there or pushes Tangalani Ndlovu on the back foot. And we see that dude, he's standing there right now. He needs to throw punches. Don't just stand there. This is a good position. The center of the ring, the judges, they can see the punches clearly, because now they are in the center of the ring.
Well, that's it. It's good, cleaner punches coming in from both boxers, but they need to throw just a few more. Matabula is certainly the crowd favorite, no doubt about that. His name being chanted just about every round here at the Big Top Arena. Matabula looking to stare down his opponent, and he would feel a little more confident now that he's seen he can put Ndlovu on the back foot. Again, Ndlovu, instead of taking the punches, is looking to move away from it. Is he going to back himself into the ropes? No, but he does respond with a couple of lefts when he is threatened to be backed up towards the ropes by Matabula.
Jeffrey Matabula is doing a very good job. He's only taking two steps forward to push Takalani Ndlovu backwards, but now he doesn't follow up. Awukho ke manje umlingo ozwenzakala la. Kudinga ukubonakala ukuthi ubani umanqoba namhlanje. Utakala Ndlovu umile uthi I am the champion. Jeffrey Matabula uthi ngona ngiyathatha namhlanje lo mdlalo. Zombili, they are beautiful.
So just over 15 seconds to go in round number 10. Of 12 in this IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship, and a wild swing from Marvelous Mongoose, but does not land. As the Panther, their left eye is not swollen progressively over the rounds, incrementally at all. But coming up after this, I can confirm that South African Lightweight Championship, also over 12 rounds, Thompson Mokwana is taking on Patrick the Hitman Malinga. The man who's fought on 36 occasions, rated South Africa's number one, but is not the champion. The South African champion is a man with 17 fights and 13 wins, Thompson Mokwana. Both men fighting out of Gauteng.
But I'm fucking shouting center.
Tonight, Bronco Sports what? Production bringing you this African Glory Tour. This IBF title center. Action here from the Big Top Arena at Carnival City. Right here on SABC 2. Broncos down in East London next weekend. If you're in the area, pop in to watch the IBF mini flyweight title bout between Nkosinathi Joy and Katasunari Takayama. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter and two premier boxers. Into the final 6 minutes here. It is round number 11 of 12. 3 minutes, 3 minutes is all that remain for either one of these boxers to land a decisive blow. Otherwise, we will go to the judges' scorecards. Judges Alfred Bukwana, Neville Hortz, and Jaap van Nieuwenhuysen, who are the three men behind the points decision for this evening's encounter. Ndlovu looks to step into it, but Matabula is not targeting that left eye of Ndlovu that's started to swell closed. Matabula's corner constantly screaming instructions, but while he continues to push Ndlovu backwards, he's seemingly lost a bit of the strategy that he had in the last couple of rounds.
That Jeffrey Matabula right now is getting more effective in throwing off his punches, and Takalani Ndlovu is a bit too slow, and there's a partner. Whoa, whilst I'm talking, a left hook from Takalani Jeffrey Matabula. Esikubona kwenzakala lana utakalani Ndlovu la kwangazathi uyehla izinga lomsebenzi. Jeffrey Matabula, he is the one that's working more harder, and as you can see, Takalani Ndlovu is moving backwards. Jeffrey Matabula is in the center of the ring, and it is not a comfortable zone for Takalani Ndlovu, the champion.
Oh, great body blow from Matabula this time around. Ndlovu misses with the right, and Matabula connects with the left. So Matabula on the ascendancy, and he's hitting that left eye now. Look at that left eye of Ndlovu. It's starting to swell just a little more. Oh, great combination blows from Matabula. Uses the reach advantage, got it for three punches, and got out of it before Ndlovu had the opportunity to respond. This time, though, tired swinging right. But Ndlovu, who's looked for much of the fight, the more confident slips. It's not going to count. It's not a knockdown, there's not going to be any count, but certainly the crowd roaring in Matabula's favour. Ndlovu very deliberately.
That was a slip game, but one thing that we are all seeing, Jeffrey Matabula is the more of the comfortable of the two right now. Jeffrey Matabula, I think he was waiting for the championship rounds with whoa, straight right, Yasala on Takalani Ndlovu's eye, which is a bit puppy right now. And I can see Jeffrey Matabula, he is making sure that he is taking this fight home to Malamulele Ojobek. We don't know.
Oh, a big right from Matabula, now looking for the combination blows. He's landing smartly, not only the blows to the head, because Ndlovu's expecting that blow to come into the eye. So every time he drops, he goes for the body. Watch this. He lands the punch left, right to the head, and then he lands a body blow. Matabula is starting to fight a lot more sense at this fight now. Great strategy, wonderful instruction from his corner as he receives constant instruction.
Now this is a fight, Dwayne. I told you, if Jeffrey Matabula can push that under backwards, Jeffrey Matabula, he is got the upper hand.
Fucking knockout. You hear me? We need to fucking put him on his ass, brother. You understand? He's fucking stealing the ass from you. Come on. You better listen to me. I shall say it.
So welcome back to the Big Top Arena here at Carnival City as we watch IBF World Junior Featherweight title between Tangalani the Panther Ndlovu and Jeffrey the Mongoose Matabula. But next up is the South African Lightweight Championship over 12 rounds. This is Patrick the Hitman Malinga, rated number one in South Africa, a man who's been fighting professionally since 1997. He is a former WBC international title weight holder and a man who has got the ability to take out Thompson Mokwana, who he faces directly after this bout. But right now into round number 12 of 12, IBF World Junior Featherweight crown of Tangalani Ndlovu is on the line, and he's got to have a big round, I would suggest, to stand any chance of taking a victory away from Matabula, who's come back strongly. When in the middle of this fight, Silence, he looked like he might be a little too tired at one stage to continue. Looked down and out, but he's landing some great punches on the left eye of Ndlovu, who's perhaps battling to see with his leading eye.
Round number 12, this is what we need to see. Jeffrey Matabula pushing Tangalani Ndlovu backwards, but Tangalani Ndlovu, he is the one that's pushing Jeffrey Matabula backwards. Agathe, Thendi Ganyo, Vanemanj, Ziyash Azombili, Pans Pezulu, Skurumon Tangalani Ndlovu la, Enzei Bugwayo, Goro Agonagali, Kwaagatu Kono Mlingo, Ozobakona. Since the fight has begun, there's no one that has went down with a solid blow. They all the rounds, they went completely and they finished the rounds. But what we need to see right now, it's either one of the boxers can knock the other out. You don't see that happening. I think this is going to go again on the judges' decision.
I can't remember when Ndlovu last landed a 1-2. Certainly Matabula's movement has been most impressive in the latter rounds of this bout. Matabula, great movement now. Hands are looking high. Confidence is high as well as these two go, trying to go toe-to-toe. Call from Nick Durant, Matabula's trainer. He wants to see the left, right, left. He wants to see that dangerous left coming, because Matabula, despite being right-handed, does have a very, very dangerous left. And it's certainly one of the tools he's used in trying to defeat Ndlovu tonight.
While she's speaking to him, an overarm right has landed on Tangalani Ndlovu's face. Jeffrey Matabula, he's pushing Tangalani Ndlovu backwards. We are shy of Tangalani Ndlovu. We are moving Jeffrey Matabula, shy Pagale in a manta. We can see that Tangalani Ndlovu, he needs to defend. But Jeffrey Matabula, he wants to win this belt tonight.
A minute remaining of this IBF World Junior Featherweight title fight. Tangalani Ndlovu looking tired now, being constantly driven back by Matabula, who's been resurgent in these latter rounds and who's looking for the decisive blow. Has he got the ability in the final few seconds of this match to take out his opponent? Ndlovu's looking tired, he's looking very weary, but perhaps not quite tired enough to be dealt with in these last few seconds.
It's only 30 seconds to go. What you see here, Tangalani Ndlovu, he is moving backwards. Jeffrey Matabula is pushing Tangalani Ndlovu backwards. Jeffrey Matabula, we are shy. Pagela is throwing 3-4 punches to Jeffrey Matabula as the challenger. This is what we need to see. When you're a challenger, you need to show the judges that you are the hungrier of the two. You need to win. And this is what Jeffrey Matabula is doing. When they show Matabula, la, Ubutu, we are shy of Tangalani Ndlovu. Tangalani Ndlovu, as yet, hasn't thrown any punches. You can see Tangalani Ndlovu in the corner. What is happening, Tangalani Ndlovu? Come back, end of the round. Round number 12.
That is the end of this 12-round IBF World Junior Featherweight title fight. Tangalani Ndlovu against Jeffrey Matabula. And Jeffrey Matabula feeling particularly confident. He finished the strongest, But Tagalainen started so strong, looked to be controlling the match, completely imposed himself on his opponent, has fallen away in these last few rounds, and you wonder just how much or how costly that will prove.
Mr. Mandiri Messina to do the belt presentation.
Great spot, and
so we wait the judge's decision as this IBF World Junior Featherweight title bout has gone the distance here at the Big Top Arena at Carnival City. It's Matabula who's confident in the belief that he's done enough to claim the IBF World title belt from Tagalainen Ndlovu. Matabula, the crowd favorite, had his name being cheered. There's the confidence, the showmanship. And the belief that says, I've got it, I know I have. And look at that left eye of Ndlovu. Towards the end of the bout, it was so swollen. Matabula having gained a great deal of confidence from some of the blows that he landed. Some impressive lefts as well, especially from round number six onwards. At round number four, he looked very, very tired. He looked a little uncertain. And until midway through this bout, was constantly being driven back by the Panther. But when he started to push Ndlovu back, he really showed dominance in this fight and made all his advantage count, his height advantage, his reach advantage, and his combination blows, silence, proved really costly for Ndlovu.
And the good thing to end that Jeffrey Matabula has been using that reach and all the punches have landed very well. As you can see right now, Jeffrey Matabula is the most comfortable and confident that he won the fight, but still, we need to go to the judges.
We're still waiting for the judges' cards to be verified and tallied, and Matabula is feeling particularly confident. Prancing around, he's celebrating early. He says, I've got the crown. He's pointing at Ndlovu's corner, saying that he's taken it. Well, the left eye doesn't look quite so bad now, but when he was taking a couple of blows, it was certainly one of the points that Matabula was trying to land punches on. Bronco Sports Production bringing you African Glory too, and it certainly has been a great fight of two boxers going toe-to-toe here at Carnival City, live on SABC2, premier action from Africa's premier promoter. And Matabula against Ndlovu is not disappointed, a highly anticipated bout that headlines a five fight card here at the Big Top Arena tonight. Still awaiting the judges' decisions, but as the boxers line up next to one another, it seems we are closer to some sort of decision. The IBF belt.
As you can see now in the ring, there's that IBF belt that we were fighting for. And you can see Jeffrey Matabula, he says, this is mine tonight.
So it seems the judges' cards have been tallied, verified. It's the IBF crown.
We have a split decision. Judge Holt scores the fight. 117, 111, Matabula. Alfred Bakwana scores the fight. 115 to 113, Nglovo. Judge Van Nieuwenhuizen scores the fine. 116 to 112. The man who came in to this ring as the IBF mandatory challenger, he leaves as the new IBF World Featherweight Champion, Jeffrey Marvelous Mangoose Matabula!
Certainly been a great deal of excitement here over 12 rounds, and unfortunate for the Panther losing out to the mandatory challenger in Jeffrey Matabula. But in terms of the fight strategy, let's find out from the man who ended up losing his crown tonight over 12 rounds. Tagalani, tough fight. Your thoughts on what was a really, really hard 12 rounds for you?
Yeah, no, it was a very close fight. No, congratulations, man, now as a challenger. You know, we've been battling for this title for some time, you know, since we fought 2010. But I'm very proud of myself, you know. This was the 40th fight, you know, fighting with him, you know. It was something else. But I'd like to say to the fans, sorry for disappointing you guys. But you know what? I think this is the time, you know. I've been long in the game, you know. But I'm not looking down. I'm looking forward to have something in the future.
Well, a future for Tagalani Ndlovu indeed. But, I mean, you had a great strategy. You had your man up against the ropes. You were driving him backward. What went wrong after round number six?
Oh, well, you know what? I can't complain much, you know. I had a problem with the cramping. I've got a problem with the legs, you know, for cramping, you know. If you cramp most of the legs, you know, because punches, they come from the legs. You can't release punches, you know. There's a thing that kept me not following the punches, but I'm very proud for what I did.
Well, disappointing in the end. Best of luck in the future.
No, thank you so much.
Tagalani, the Panther and Lobo, unfortunately losing out his title, but certainly one man who is particularly excited is the man who now holds the crown, fighting with Nick Durant in his corner. Championships before, he's claimed WBC international featherweight titles before as well, a former South African super bantamweight title holder as well is Jeffrey Matabula.
This is the highly rated weight division in our country. As we can remember, we had Welcome Nita fighting for the very same title. We have Beyond the Beast, Pungu. We had the likes of Lisogonolo, Hands of Tony Dava for light featherweight. Right now, it is Jeffrey Matabula against Tagalani Ndlovu. Zombili ziyashaya, ayike funa ubuyele emuva. But right now, as you can see, Tagalani Ndlovu is the one that's pushing Jeffrey Matabula backwards.
Oli Snowball saying for the second time that Jeffrey Matabula has just landed punches a little low on the body of Ndlovu. So Oli Snowball with an early warning, no points deductions as yet. Good little left coming in from Ndlovu. The two boxers still sizing one another up, but the pace has slowed down just slightly. Nice little jab and looking for the combination blow. Matabula, who's seemingly the aggressor in this second round so far, but the Panther himself now guilty of landing blows that are just a little too low in the eye of referee Wally Snowball, who's been right on the money so far.
Jeffrey Matabula is not the boxer who's very comfortable fighting on his back foot. And right now, Tagalani Ndlovu, he's putting Jeffrey Matabula on his back. Right now, what you see right now, Jeffrey Matabula, he tries to make sure that he's pushing Tagalani Ndlovu backwards. But Tagalani, he is the champion. He is ruling this ring. He's controlling the fight.
Well, that's the thing. If you've got the momentum going forward, you can easily push your opponent into the ring. And as you say, you rightly say, Matabula, despite his attempts to land those punches on Ndlovu, he's not exactly driving Ndlovu back. And when you fail to get that momentum moving as opposed to your the opponent in the ring with you, things can go horribly wrong. You can get driven back into the ropes. You can find yourself caught as, in some cases, the superior boxer takes charge. But who is the superior boxer is what we're aiming to find out over 12 rounds tonight. IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. It's Ndlovu against Matabula.
This is boxing. This is what's happening. They will say local is local.
Another warning from Wally Snowball. Don't push your man down. But this is certainly a star-studded card for African Glory 2. And these are the two men who highlight the fight card. Again, looking to land that big left is Matabula. He's using it more than simply as a jab. A nice little body landed. And now, wanting the combinations is Ndlovu coming in with the punches.
This is the fight that we all like to see. We are waiting for Geoffrey Matabula to stand at least at the center of the ring and start throwing crisp punches and the thrilling punches. But right now, Takala Ndlovu, he is the one that's pushing forward and making sure that he stamps his authority that says, I am the champion tonight.
He certainly imposed his himself on his opponents in the opening two rounds.
We've got a double jab. Okay. He's slipping, bang, throwing right in when you jab one. I want plenty fines this round, plenty fines, and double jab, three jab. He's on your left. The centers are working. He's going to go back and then he's going to go there. So center, step here, pick him up. Okay. 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 Deep, it's all the time. It's all right, it's all right. So far it's good, but when he misses over your head, I need you to work.
So welcome back to Carnival City. It's the Big Top Arena as Bronco Sports brings you African Glory 2. It's IBF title action here from the Big Top Arena. It's certainly premier action from Africa's premier promoter, the only man to have been voted the IBF's promoter of the world for 3 years in a row. Bear in mind, we've got a fight down in East London next weekend for you. If you're going to be down in East London, it is IBF mini flyweight crown that's up for grabs. And of course, tonight to joy against Katasunari Takayama. Down in East London is the fight. Make sure you get on down and watch the match. And right now, the focus very much on the Panther against the Mongoose. It's still Takalani Ndlovu imposing himself on his opponent by constantly moving forward. But he does need to land a few more punches. He's not landing the body blows that you would expect from Takalani Ndlovu. Credit to the movement of Matabula.
Geoffrey Matabula, he is the awkward boxer in terms of his stance. It's very difficult to hit such an awkward boxer simply because he is tall. Geoffrey Matabula, Mute Lumpana, we are Sebenzisa Ingale Zinde, Takalani Ndlovu, we are Ngena, we are Princess Otushai Pagale in Amanda, Ebonagalayo, Zilele Lavafana Wabili, Bashai Pagale in Amanda, go to Balegla, Udu Geoffrey Matabula, when the show, Udi Pagala Shai, Takalani Ndlovu, I sali, Esiswini, no my salepsuini, Bakela, Geoffrey Matabula, the mangoes, Zindala Zombie.
It's great to see how Matabula is adapting at the moment, because while he's not able to drive Ndlovu back, what he's able to do is he's able to land a couple of punches and move, and that's what he's been impressive with so far in this round. His movement through the ring, great footwork, lands a couple of punches, gets the move on the way if he's not pushing Ndlovu backwards. And this is something that certainly a strategy that Matabula could gain some success with if he continues to fight this way. But one body blow landed by Ndlovu. Matabula just a little jab through between the gloves of Ndlovu. It was just holding those hands a little high, a little holding coming in. Call a break from referee Snowball.
Takalani Matabula, he is the boxer that is he's a body puncher. He throws a lot of body punches. We are seeing Geoffrey Matabula throwing body punches. Takalani Ndlovu, umpana la waziwaka kulu okushayi bagela ashayi siswin, indio diveli well. Koro namthanga esponu Geoffrey Matabula uye no shayi bagela la ashayi siswin abuye kanda. Zindi bagela zaka Geoffrey Matabula. Geoffrey Matabula in left hand yake iyatla kakulu. He is dropping his left hand Geoffrey Matabula and is using those long arms to make sure that he's keeping Takalani Ndlovu at bay.
And he's managing to do that infinitely better in this third round as we approach the final 30 seconds of round number three. Looking a little wary from throwing the punches, but he's backed himself into a corner, and again, great movement out. He's not finding himself caught up against the ropes, which is something that he would need to be wary of, being driven back by his opponent. Nice left from Ndlovu. Lands the left. He's been throwing a few wildly. Lands another big left now. And some power blows coming in from Ndlovu, but you're into the final 10 seconds. A little clinching going on from the two boxers again. Good bobbing and weaving, but still a few punches being landed. None of them comfortably, though, as we hit the end of round number three.
Two distinctions between the two boxers. Declan Ndlovu is very economical. He never wakes any punches. As Jeffrey Matebula, he throws four or five, but then all of them, they don't land.
Well, if you're a big fan next Friday, bear in mind Broncos' focus moving to East London for a boxing bonanza. Kusunati Joy against Katsunara Takayama of Japan for the IBF Mini Flyweight Crown. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter, but tonight the focus on African glory too. This IBF title action, it is the Panther against the marvelous mongoose Matebula, who had a few more blows landed in the second half, but a good strong finish from Ndlovu. But you go back to 2 years ago and the initial meeting between these two. Start of round number four. This is the highly anticipated rematch for the IBF Junior Featherweight Crown here at the Big Top Arena at Carnival City. Rather controversial, their meeting in 2010, I suppose, looking at the rather contrasting scorecards on the evening, and certainly Matebula's camp doing the decisions of the judges. Only out for Nivenes, and it scored in favor of Matebula on the evening. But now the two going toe-to-toe. Watch your head, watch your head. Wally Snowball, as the two heads bob and weave almost together at one stage. But Ndlovu trying to land the power punches, and Matebula swinging a little wildly.
Now umdlalo ke manje uyaliwa la. Jeffrey Matebula ushayibhakele inamandla, kodwa sibona shaya khulu ngamandla la. Takalani Ndlovu ubuyile, uTakalani Ndlovu wenza into esimjwayele ngayo, ukushaya esiswini, abuye futhi akhuphuke phezulu. This is what we see Jeffrey Matebula right now trying to do, to make sure that he's throwing as much punches as he can. But one thing that Jeffrey Matebula must not do, he must not overwork himself. It's still early in the rounds. Takalani Ndlovu is very economical in punch throw. Look at that. 1-2, they are landing crisp on Jeffrey Matebula's face.
Well, that's the worry now for Matebula, is Ndlovu is starting to land a lot more clean punches. Matebula is not having any power in the punches that he is landing. Ndlovu seemingly completely unbothered by any of Matebula's attempts to make a clean connection. Matebula being driven into a corner, and he's not backing out of it now. Eventually he does. But it's such a contrast from the last round, where he was moving so cleanly, great movement around the ring. Suddenly, Matebula is looking a lot more tired, and while a good weave, it's certainly not great defense from Matebula. Even when he does get the arms up, sometimes just far too big a gap between the gloves. Matebula is taking an extra odd second to get up off the bench. Coming into round number seven, Ndlovu still standing in the corner.
Jeffrey Matebula is very suspicious on dropping his guards, whilst Takalani Ndlovu is always on his guards and making sure that he's throwing the power punches. But Jeffrey Matebula, round number six, he came back very strong, trying to make sure that he is winning the round and getting on the back. Jeffrey Matebula lo siyambona ke manje uyimisele, ziyaphakama kancane izandla, kodwa kubalulekile la ukuthi kufanele ukuthi ashaye ibhakela ezothi uma wakhwela umzuliswano ube uye ohambe phambili. Wayishaye left Jeffrey Matebula, ushintshile umfana la, uye manje umile at the center of the ring, akasabuyele move. He's not going back to Jeffrey Matebula here.
That's exactly what you want now. Matebula to stand firm and take this toe-to-toe at the center of the ring. You want to see the two boxers fighting at the center of the ring. But Ndlovu again, impose. That's his strategy tonight, and he's trying to fight his own way. But he's still managing to take the punches. A few of them landed by Matebula, in particular a nice left. Oh, and this time he does find a combination. And that's the type of thing that Matabula needs to do. If he can land a couple of those big punches, he can take the title away from Ndlovu in a matter of seconds. But yep. Ndlovu needs to go back to what he was doing. Quick movement, push forward, use the power rather than be intimidated by the reach advantage of his opponent.
Jeffrey Matabula is looking very comfortable in the center of the ring, but now once he starts to move as he's doing right now and uses the rope, he looks very clumsy. And Ntakalani Ndlovu, that's his tap. He needs to always attack. Whoa, straight right. Yes, Jeffrey Matabula, he needs to lift that left hand because here is Mfake Ngozini la. Zizibambeni insizwa la. Jeffrey Matabula, Ntakalani Ndlovu, zidlalile 2010. Sifuna ukubona namhlanje 2012 lo ukuthi ubani la ozophuma being the champion. Ngubani uManqoba? Who is the winner tonight?
Well, Jeffrey is the call all around the ring as they sense a resurgence from Nick Durant's boxer. Matabula looking to bring in a couple of heavy lifts. He's not exactly landed any haymakers, but he's certainly getting a few more punches in round number seven. Matabula, tired right coming in towards Ndlovu, who still looks a very confident boxer, trying to box like a champion, but finds himself off balance a few times in this round, and that might just be the difference. Perhaps one of those blows has caused the difference. Ndlovu is not quite as steady as he was just last round.
Exactly, Ntakalani Ndlovu here, what we can see, he's always just moving, he's using the short steps to attack Jeffrey Matabula. Jeffrey Matabula, his punches, they are not actually powerful as they were before. But now, the guard is very down. He's starting to be comfortable. One mistake Jeffrey Matabula, he needs not to do, is to get too relaxed and play around. This IPF, it's a world title fight. We need to be serious on this one.
Peter Mensah watches on. Vuzo Mbebe, who's the man, will be heading up the organization for the 2013 Africa Cup of Nations. But this is where Matabula really landed a couple of big punches. Yes, Ndlovu responded with a couple of his own. But that left eye of Ndlovu is starting to look just a little swollen, and it might very well have been from that right.
It's because of the overarm right that Jeffrey Matabula is always throwing. He is Jeffrey Matabula, the one that's hitting the body more than Ntakalani Ndlovu on this one.
Well, Matabula landed a couple of really big blows, and that left eye is certainly not close to being swollen shut, but it's just looking a little more closed than the opponent. That's the opponent, Matabula, fighting out of Durant's gym. IBF title fight. This World Junior Featherweight Championship will be decided over 12 rounds. The man who fights out of Brakpan in Gauteng, Jeffrey the Mongoose Matabula, up against IBF world champion, ranked number 6 by Ring Magazine, the Panther Ndlovu. And after the dominance that Matabula showed in the last round, wanting to try to respond immediately, and Ndlovu is landing a couple of punches, but Matabula is saying, I'm going to take you toe to toe and I'm not going to back down.
Both boxers are revived right now. You can see the number of punches that they are throwing. And one good thing that I love now, they are using the center of the ring. They are not always using the ropes. Jeffrey Matabula, he is now trying to throw more punches. Jeffrey Matabula, umfana oyimisela kakhulu la, uyasebenzisa ingalo zakhe ezinde, uyayiphonsa ijab, iyahlala. Ntakalani Ndlovu umile, uthi anginawo Jeffrey Matabula, iqhuda manikile, uyashawuta Jeffrey Matabula, yahlala esiswini. Kwangalo Ntakalani Ndlovu naye angabuye futhi enze njalo, ashaya adume ngazo to hit the body and come back on top.
Well, Jeffrey Matabula, interestingly, has only fought twice since he lost to Ntakalani Ndlovu back in September of 2010. But in that time, there's not been a great deal of fighting either from his opponent, Ntakalani Ndlovu, who's only had 4 fights in the last 2.5-odd years. So between the two, not quite showing any ring rustiness.
Jeffrey Matabula there, he's using the ring very well. He is pretending as if he's going to the corner, then he switches and twists. This is what we like to see in boxing. You need to tell your opponent, thinking maybe doing this when doing the other thing.
Good movement from Jeffrey Matabula in particular, while the stance of Ndlovu has been impressively holding is the warning from Wally Snowball. He has not come close to suggesting any points deductions are on the cards tonight, but just trying to man-manage both boxers.
Powerful right hand, it has landed on Jeffrey Mathebula's face. Utakalani Ndlovulo, ulokumile, uyampusha Jeffrey Mathebula. Gabu Jeffrey Mathebula, he is the challenger. He's the one that says, tonight, this IBF belt, ngiyayithatha ngihamba nayo, I'm taking this belt away.
Interesting to note, just our Mathebula, who was standing with a slightly wider stance in his feet earlier on in the round. His feet are coming a lot more closer together. He's standing even more upright than he was at the start of the bout. And perhaps just signs of tiredness. But Ndlovu, who looked to have been hurt in round number 7, is looking strong again in round number 8. Taking another couple of taps to the forehead, but no decisive blows. Another left landed by Mathebula as Ndlovu lands a couple of jabs. Going for the gum guard now is Ndlovu, getting caught near the ropes, but still not landing the punches. Ndlovu again. Mathebula's movement has been most impressive in avoiding some of those big blows, but he is still far from dominating this fight, I suggest, Jeffrey Mathebula. So welcome back to the Big Top Arena. It is Carnival City as Bronco Sports brings you African Glory 2. The IBF title action on the cards tonight is the big fight, the IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. That's the man that is going to fight the victor. Well, he's watching on with a great deal of interest. Rated number 3.
That's a handsome boy, the boxer we've seen here. This is our current South African junior featherweight champion, which is Makbutsi Nyambi. He's rated number 3 by IPF. Anytime soon, he might fight the winner of the two. I said it before, I'm saying it now. This is a very, very powerful division in our country. Makbutsi Nyambi, Takalani Ndlovu, Jeffrey Mathebula. Takalani Ndlovu will be eligible right now. Jeffrey Mathebula, he's throwing the punches, body blows, and finishes on top. 4, 5, 6 punches. Ziyasha Namanje Nsizwa. This is the mix. This is what you want to see.
But perhaps this is, it is certainly what you want to see. But both these fighters having fought international opponents. The difference, though, is Mathebula's fought all his fights in South Africa. Takalani Ndlovu's got the experience of having fought in Mexico. He's fought in Canada. He's fought in the United States. He's fought some of the biggest names in boxing. He's fought Guerrero. I mean, he lost out to Molitor and then came back and beat Molitor. He's taken on Giovanni Caro in Mexico, and he's beaten him. So Takalani Ndlovu has got to say, it's got the superior pedigree when it comes to these boxers. You fought Rafael Marquez, probably one of the greatest boxers ever. You fought him twice over in the States. What does that add to the boxer's pedigree?
I agree with you, Dwayne, on that one, because now what actually happens here, you come back with more confidence and you know the experience is there. But one thing I can say, the local fights, those are the most difficult fights, because to grow up together, we know each other, and now the pride, it's always the telling point that who's the best in the country.
Well, this is almost bordering on the ridiculous as the two get to know each other a little better. Ronnie Snubble decides he's going to send a warning the way of
Ngus Mathebula. We'll be right back. the man he loves to hate, Takalani Nglowo. This is the IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship, and it's scheduled for 12 rounds. And your officials for this particular fight are none other than Judge Alfred Bakwani, Neville Holtz, and Jean van Nieuwenhuizen. The supervisor for this fight hails from Tanzania, so let's give him a nice warm round of applause. Onesco Ngowi. Let me introduce the principals to you right now. He weighed in at 55.32 kilograms. He's the former WBC international champion. He's the former IBO international champion. He has a fight record of 30 fights, 25 wins, 14 by knockout, lost three, drawn two. He goes by the name of Jeffrey Marvelous Mongoose Matabula. His opponent tonight, a man who needs no introduction to the South African ring. He is, of course, the IBF world champion. He weighed in at 55.18 kilograms with a fight record of 39 fights, 33 wins, 18 by knockout. He's only lost six. Soweto Gauteng's very own Takalani the Panther Nglowo. Now when the bell rings and the action begins in this four-cornered ring, the third man will be referee Wally Snowball. Boxers.
I'm Dwayne DeLocke alongside me, Silence Mabuza, for this most anticipated fight in South Africa. An IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship over 12 rounds between Takalani the Panther Nglowo and Jeffrey Marvelous Mongoose Matabula. Well, the 34-year-old Nglowo certainly favoured by many, but a bit of a grudge rematch as they meet for the second time. It was Nglowo who emerged victorious the first time that they met, and certainly Matabula, better prepared, comes into this fight with a lot more confidence, and the tail of the tape suggests that Matabula, with his reach advantage and his height advantage, might make it count tonight. But he's up against a slightly more experienced fighter. Both have impressive records, though. Silence, what do you make of this title bout?
This is a highly anticipated fight for the night. Number one, as you can see, Takalani Nglowo, the champion, he's very clinical in his punch throwing, and he's very accurate. Whilst Jeffrey Matabula, he tries with his reach of advantage, and he throws a lot of punches. The boys, they have been into the ring, in the very same ring, and the very same arena before. That was 2010. We need to see who is going to win this fight tonight. But both boxers, they are fit and ready to take it on.
Certainly are. Both boxers having in recent years registered victories over men like Oscar Choke, but certainly Tagalani Ndlovu, his victory over Steve Molitor, the Canadian, to claim the IBF Super Bantamweight title, or the IBF Junior Featherweight title, if you prefer. A man that beat Ndlovu at their first time of asking in Canada, brought him out to South Africa and managed to claim victory and the belt. He looks to defend it against Matabula tonight. But these boxers, early indications are that they're willing to go toe-to-toe with one another. And you so usually expect that from grudge matches, and certainly matches or rematches or title deciders. Unlike some of the bouts that we saw on the undercard, this is going to be one of those where the boxers are going to be willing to go toe-to-toe for the duration of the fight.
It is very evident this is a weight class boxing. You can see Zindala Zombil, Jeffrey Matebula, Utakala Ndlovu, Ziyashana Lensizwa Lezi. We have round number one lo, Kepa Ike Shoni Penye, Zombili, Zipunugu in a Lom Dalo, one Amtanja. We have born Jeffrey Matebula, Bisela Kunamtanja. We are Shaway Semizan like Zinde, Utakala Ndlovu. He is very popular in his defense. They are both throwing power punches. It's first round, it is hot.
It is hot indeed. It's been titled African Glory 2, and it's all about African Glory. The Panther up against the Mongoose Ndlovu. He's a lot more crouched in his start. He's got great balance. And you expect that from somebody who's fought at the highest level. Matebula slightly more upright, but does like to use that reach advantage. These boxers, though, are both orthodox boxers, no southpaw. So nothing overly difficult for either one of the opponents to worry about, certainly in terms of stance. These two sizing each other up, and a little holding going on.
The difference between the two boxers, Dwayne, is that Tagalani Ndlovu is very comfortable in boxing against a boxer. And Jeffrey Matebula, he's a slack fist. What he wants to do, he tries to play it rough. But right now, it's the first round. Both boxers, they are holding, they are playing it rough. And this is Jeffrey Matebula's step. This is how he likes the fight.
Well, complaints certainly from the Panthers camps, from Marvelous's camp about a few possible rabbit punches, but no call from referee Wally Snowball. So the end of round one, and boxers signaling their intentions. So fighting out of the No Mercy gym, Tagalani the Panther Ndlovu, the champion, IBF world champion, rated by Ring Magazine as number 6 in the junior featherweight division. The man who's lost only 6 of his 39 bouts, bringing up number 40 and hoping to claim victory once again, successfully defend his title. But the Mongoose, the mandatory challenger, is a man who is looking to take it away from him. He's fought for Matebula, but these two boxers both looking a little weary now in round number 9 of 12 in this IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. It's Ndlovu who's standing, biding his time, just feeling out Matebula, who swings wildly and doesn't really connect, but lands a few combinations. Needs to focus on a point and perhaps go for it.
Jeffrey Matebula is back. As you can see, he is the one now that's throwing more punches. Ushayi Bagele in a man, Jeffrey Matebula, ziyabonakala la. But one thing that I don't like Jeffrey Matebula to do, once he gets you, he starts to be too relaxed and too comfortable, and he makes a lot of mistakes. You don't want to see that. This is the IPF world title fight. You need to be extra careful because every second counts.
Doesn't matter how dominant you are in the ring, you find yourself on the receiving end from your opponent if you do get overly cocky or if you do drop your guard. It's happened so often. A boxer will be dominant 10 rounds of 12 and in the 11th take a blow to the chin. Both these boxers throwing a few slightly less venomous punches in round number 9. 3 rounds to go. It's Tagalani Ndlovu taking on Jeffrey Matebula for this IBF Junior Featherweight crown. Some nice bloody blows landed by Matebula, and as you mentioned, Silence, there were some decent punches that Matebula started to come back with, and yes, in these latter rounds looked like he's got a second wind.
This is the round that Jeffrey Matebula has came back very strong, and the previous round, what we need to see from Jeffrey Matebula is to stand there and throw punches, don't play around.
He's staring down his opponents. He believes that he can beat Tagalane Ndlovu tonight. Ndlovu remains standing throughout his break between rounds. So into round number 10 we go. Both corners a little slow in getting their boxes out of the corners. So into round number 10, Matebula comes out with intent, doesn't quite land his opening strike, but Ndlovu responds with a little jab just between the gloves, landing the left now. And Ndlovu going about it a little more deliberately, but he's landing some of those left jabs.
Now this is a very closely concerted fight, because now Jeffrey Matebula is also coming back with his strong punches, whilst Tagalane Ndlovu, he was relaxed in the past two rounds, but still, it's still early. This is a championship round. Round number 10, both boxers, they are still fit, they are still there, they are fighting. Ziyashayana, Okshio, Zindala Zombili, Ayika Funukovu Pondo, Yinyinkuzo Melipu Mesfayen, Orwa Umbuzo Uti, Yiipi, which is the one that's going to come up top tonight.
Well, now look at this. This is the first time that we're starting to see. Mongoose is pushing back the Panther just slightly, ever so slightly, and Ndlovu is starting to box on his back foot. He's got some weight on his heels, and that'll send a signal to Matebula that I'm doing something right. And he'll be pushing for, look at that again, Ndlovu is starting to step back, which we've not seen in previous rounds. He's continued to take the punches and move forward, but now Ndlovu is.
Tagalane Ndlovu is not comfortable fighting on his back foot, but now Jeffrey Matebula, he tried to push back Tagalane Ndlovu. Yet again, he's still the one that's moving back. He needs to stay there or pushes Tagalane Ndlovu on the back foot. And we see that dude, he's standing there right now. He needs to throw punches. Don't just stand there. This is a good position. The center of the ring, the judges, they can see the punches clearly, because now they are in the center of the ring.
Well, that's it. It's good, cleaner punches coming in from both boxers, but they need to throw just a few more. Matebula is certainly the crowd favorite, no doubt about that. His name being chanted just about every round here at the Big Top Arena. Matebula looking to stare down his opponent, and he would feel a little more confident now that he's seen he can put Ndlovu on the back foot again. Ndlovu, instead of taking the punches, is looking to move away from it. Is he going to back himself into the ropes? No, but he does respond with a couple of lefts when he is threatened to be backed up towards the ropes by Matebula.
Jeffrey Matebula is doing a very good job. He's only taking two steps forward to push Tagalane Ndlovu backward, but now he doesn't follow up. Awukho ke manje umlingo ozwenzakala la. Kudinga ukubonakala ukuthi ubani umanqoba namhlanje. Tagalane Ndlovu umile uthi I am the champion. Jeffrey Matebula uthi ngikhona ngiyawuthatha namhlanje lo mdlalo. Zombili, they are beautiful.
So just over 15 seconds to go in round number 10 of 12 in this IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship, and a wild swing from Marvelous Mongoose, but does not land. As the Panther, their left eye is not swollen progressively over the rounds, incrementally at all. But coming up after this, I can confirm that South African Lightweight Championship, also over 12 rounds, Thompson Mokoena is taking on Patrick the Hitman Malinga, the man who's fought on 36 occasions, rated South Africa's number one, but is not the champion. The South African champion is a man with 17 fights and 13 wins, Thompson Mokoena. Both men fighting out of Gauteng. But
I'm fucking shouting center.
Tonight, Bronco Sports Production bringing you this African Glory 2. This IBF title action here from the Big Top Arena at Carnival City. Right here on SABC 2. Broncos down in East London next weekend. If you're in the area, pop in to watch the IBF mini flyweight title bout between Nkosinathi Joy and Katasunari Takayama. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter and two premier boxers. Into the final 6 minutes here. It is round number 11 of 12. 3 minutes, 3 minutes is all that remain for either one of these boxers to land a decisive blow. Otherwise, we will go to the judges' scorecards. Judges Alpha Bukpana, Neville Hortz, and Jaap van Nieuwenhuysen, who are the three men behind the points decision for this evening's encounter. Ndlovu looks to step into it, but Matebula is not targeting that left eye of Ndlovu that's started to small closed. Matabula's corner constantly screaming instructions, but while he continues to push Ndlovu backwards, he's seemingly lost a bit of the strategy that he had in the last couple of rounds.
Jeffrey Matabula right now is getting more effective in throwing off his punches, and Takalendo is actually too slow, and there's a partner. Whoa, whilst I'm talking, a left hook from Jacqueline Matabula. Esikubona kwenzakala lana uTakalendovu la wangazathi uyehla izinga lomsebenzi. Jeffrey Matabula, he is the one that's working more harder, and as you can see, Takalendovu is moving backwards. Jeffrey Matabula is in the center of the ring, and it is not a comfortable zone for Takalendovu, the champion.
Oh, great body blow from Matabula this time around. Global misses with the right, and Matabula connects with the left. So Matabula on the ascendancy, and he's hitting that left eye now. Look at that left eye of Ndlovu. It's starting to swell just a little more. Oh, great combination blows from Matabula. Uses the reach advantage, got it for three punches, and got out of it before Ndlovu had the opportunity to respond. This time, though, tired swinging right, but Ndlovu, who's looked for much of the fight, the more confident slips. It's not going to count. It's not a knockdown, there's not going to be any count, but certainly the crowd roaring in Matabula's favour. Ndlovu very deliberately.
That was a slip game, but one thing that we are all seeing, Jeffrey Matabula is the more of the comfortable of the two right now. Jeffrey Matabula, I think he was waiting for the championship rounds with whoa, straight right, Yasala on Takalani Ndlovu's eye, which is a bit puppy right now. And I can see Jeffrey Matabula, he is making sure that he is taking this fight home to Malamulele or Jobek, we don't know.
Oh, big right from Matabula, now looking for the combination blows. He's landing smartly, not only the blows to the head, because Ndlovu was expecting that blow to come into the eye. So every time he drops, he goes to the body. Watch this. He lands the punch left, right to the head, and then he lands a body blow. Matabula is starting to fight a lot more sensitive fight now. Great strategy. Wonderful instruction from his corner as he receives constant instruction.
Now this is a fight, Dwayne. I told you, if Jeffrey Matabula can push that under backwards, Jeffrey Matabula, he is got the upper hand.
Knockout. You hear me? We need to fight them 15 on his ass, brother. You understand? He's fucking skinning the ass on you. Come on. You better listen to me. I shall say it.
So welcome back to the Big Top Arena here at Carnival City as we watch IBF World Junior Featherweight title between Tagalani. The pack came in. He's is looking far from the man who was bouncing around. 1-2 combinations, jump, 1-2, nice movement that he was in the last round. Another body blow from Ndlovu.
Jeffrey Matabula right now, he's fighting Takalani Ndlovu's fight. Jeffrey Matabula, he needs to run around and confuse Takalani Ndlovu. But Jeffrey Matabula, he is moving slow. And Takalani Ndlovu is just catching Jeffrey Matabula right at the center of the ring. Takalani Ndlovu, lo, the champion of the Mzanje, challenge leo, mkelingeni la, taku Jeffrey Matabula. When the show, Takalani Ndlovu, Ubud is throwing the most powerful punches.
Ndlovu is certainly getting the better of Matabula. And round number four, in terms of landing superior punches, cleaner punches, crisper punches, another left makes a combination. Trying to box his way off the rings. Landing on the head of Ndlovu, but nothing hurting the champion. It's the champion who is imposing himself. But now, a little slip, nearly saw him go into the rings with Matabula, but he looks fresh and confident at the conclusion of round number four.
Jeffrey Matabula.
Thank you. So African Glory 2 tonight, IBF title action from Carnival City. It's live on SABC2. Kosanati Joy, Katusunari Takayama is going to be next Friday down in East London. Make sure you go and watch the IBF mini flyweight crown if you're in the area. It's premier action from Africa's premier promoter, the only man who's been voted IBF's promoter of the world for 3 years in a row, Branko Milankovic, the man behind Branko Sports, and of course tonight's bout. In association with Gauteng, home of champions in Carnival City Casino. And African Glory 2 so far is living up to expectation. These two boxers have showed a great deal of different strategies, different tactics, as a big right comes in from Ndlovu.
This is what
took it cleanly though.
This is what we don't want to see between Jeffrey Matevula dropping that left hand, because Takalendov has got a very vicious straight right. We saw that happening. He dropped the left, Jeffrey Matevula, and Takalendov, he threw a very powerful right which landed crisp on the face of Jeffrey Matevula.
Well, the one thing that nobody could ever accuse Takalendov of being is somebody who lacks stamina. He's got a great endurance. He's got the ability to go 12 rounds if indeed the fight is going to go that far. Matebula might be a little more concerned in terms of taking the fight the distance. Again, being driven back, landing the blows, but into the arms of Matebula, who's laying them up a little more frequently now in protection. But those arms are dropping overall, and if Ndlovu times it right, could get in the blow that proves decisive in this fight.
Takalani Ndlovu, we are umpana la opusha Jeffrey Matebula mover. Jeffrey Matebula, we are shy in Billy, shy in Data, shy in Takalani Ndlovu, shy in Billy, the Stalin's uncle, Talibus Wenda, Jeffrey Matebula umile, Udio Mutasha and Amma Jeffrey Matebula. Jeffrey Matebula needs to work even more harder, but make sure that whatever punch he's throwing, it lands, because Takalani Ndlovu, he throws all the crisp punches.
But it's not to say that Matebula is out of this fight, not by any stretch of the imagination. He's certainly not having the advantage, but in boxing, the great thing about bouts is how uncertain they can be, and how often somebody who's dominated a fight for 10 rounds can suddenly lose it with one blow. All it needs is a clean left, a clean right, great uppercut.
This is still early in the fight. We can see Takalani Ndlovu is still pushing Jeffrey Matebula backwards. Jeffrey Matebula, uyabamba, ubele muva, akasashayi ibhakela eningi kakhulu Jeffrey Matebula. Ziyehla izandla. He's dropping his hands. I don't know whether Jeffrey Matebula is tired or what, but one thing for sure, a boxer from Nicturand is always fit when it comes to the fight.
Yes, indeed, but you've got to say that despite the fact that Ndlovu's landed all these punches, he hasn't drawn blood. He's not got the eye swollen. So he's not really doing as much damage as he would have hoped to his opponent tonight. Matebula's taking the body blows. Are they wearing him out? Most likely. But Ndlovu for now is looking slightly healthier, fitter, and the man likely to go the distance. But the fact that Matebula is able to get himself out of the corner, out of the off the ring when he's back into that situation, suggests that there's still life in the fighter and that he's not out of this fight.
Jeffrey Matebula, he is the boxer that's sitting down in every interval. See now, that was a straight right I was talking about. Jeffrey Matebula dropped the left, and Takalani Ndlovu, he threw a straight right. Jeffrey Matebula was a uppercut la, umlomo uvulekile. Uhlala phansi Jeffrey Matebula on the intervals, but Takalani Ndlovu, he is standing up even on the intervals. That shows how fit the boxers can be.
Well, Takalani Ndlovu is got slightly more experience as well, and as Silence rightly mentions, even during the breaks, he's not resting on his bench in his corner. Instead, the man in the red corner, Takalani Ndlovu, is instead standing, intimidating his opponent, trying any psychological ploy to gain an advantage. Matebula is not playing his game though, and he's looking to gain or use all the advantages he has, certainly in height and reach, to try to outbox Ndlovu.
Kuyaliwa lana namhlanje. Jeffrey Matebula uqelenzelela ichallenger. Takalani Ndlovu, he's the champion. Kuyaliwa la. Ngithatha ukubona ukwazi lana uTakalani Ndlovu, uyu mpana ofuna ukuqeda lo mdlalo ngoba before uTakalani Ndlovu, he won the fight, but then Jeffrey Matebula said, "No, I was the one." But the boys, they said, "Tonight we don't have to leave the fight to the judges. We need to finish this now here and there, finish."
Alfred Bukwana, Neville Hortz, and Yap on Nibonese, and all the three judges for tonight's bout. This IBF World Junior Featherweight Championship. Over 12 rounds, we're in round number 6. And in recent times, I can tell you that Takalani Ndlovu has lost his knockout edge. He's gone the distance in his last 7 fights. So in terms of the knockout blow, it's been lacking over the last 4-odd years. But that doesn't mean that he is an inferior boxer. He's a champion, and he's looking to prove it again with a successful title defense against Geoffrey Matabula. And, of course, claim a second successive victory over the man who fights from Nick Durant's corner. Durant's boxing against No Mercy Gym.
This is one of the very tough weight division, and it's the most exciting weight division in our country, because we've got the likes of Makbut Sinyabi, who also is our South African junior featherweight champion. I'd love to see Makbut Sinyabi fighting against Geoffrey Matabula or Takalani Ndlovu. But right now, Takalani Ndlovu, he is pushing Geoffrey Matabula backwards.
Matabula continues to find himself on the back foot and more toward the ropes, as Ndlovu just oozes confidence. Ndlovu's stance, so impressive, hasn't changed. Crouched over, Matabula slightly more upright, swinging wildly at times and showing signs of tiredness.
Geoffrey Matabula is doing what is very famous on. He's throwing 3-4 punches, but one thing that he's doing wrong, he doesn't make sure that those punches land, because every punch that you miss, it takes away the power.
It does. It takes away a great deal of energy. Throwing punches and missing your opponents takes probably more energy than it does landing the punches, or in fact having punches landed on you, taking the blows. Both these boxers have a chin, though. They're not easy boxers to knock out, but both will hope that they have what it takes to take out their opponent. Right now, I'd suggest that Ndlovu is the boxer who's really styling his way to a title defense rather than fighting his way. Matabula trying to throw those wild punches and hoping with every swing that he can land a miracle punch. So tonight, Bronco Sports, he's the man behind it, brings you African Glory 2, this IBF title action from the Big Top Arena here at Carnival City, live on SABC 2. To focus on East London next Friday with Kusunata Joy and Katsunara Takayama. IBF mini flyweight crown up for grabs. Premier action from Africa's premier promoter. And Marvelous Mongoose taking a couple of punches here as the Panther gets tucked in. He's on the hunt, is the Panther. And it looks like Mongoose is on the menu.